हार्टी वेलकम टू एवरीवन। सो यस्टरडे वी सॉ अबाउट और यस्टरडे वी स्टडीड अबाउट द रिलेशन बिटवीन रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर एंड फोकल लेंथ फॉर बोथ द मिरर्स कॉनकेव एंड कॉन्वेक्स मिरर एंड आल्सो यस्टरडे वी टोल्ड दैट द फोकल लेंथ ऑफ अ मिरर डिपेंड्स ओनली ऑन द रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर। वी प्रूव्ड इट विद द हेल्प ऑफ द एक्सप्रेशन इटसेल्फ। ओके सो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल बी लर्निंग अबाउट फ्यू रूल्स ऑफ फाइंडिंग इमेज। इमेज फॉर्मेशन होते वक्त कुछ रूल्स हैं, विच रूल्स शुड बी फॉलोड वाइल एट द टाइम ऑफ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ इमेज, दैट रूल्स वी नीड टू स्टडी टूडे हेयर इन शॉर्ट। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग इट, लेट मी टेल यू दैट देयर आर बेसिक फोर रूल्स टू फाइंड एन इमेज फॉर्म बाय अ कॉन्केव मिरर। रूल्स to find image formed by concave mirror. So while we are studying about these rules, so first of all we should start with the four basic rules. So let me draw the diagrams for the rules too. So we will be studying our first rule itself. Just suppose that this is a spherical mirror within its own. As we all know that parallel axis passes through the center of the sphere and the pole itself. Okay. Then we also know that for a concave mirror, a ray is incident. Suppose that the ray is parallel to the principal axis. This ray falls at point B, which is parallel to the principal axis. Then at that time, this ray passes through the focus itself. This ray passes through the focus itself. It is the first rule. The first rule. What is the first rule? The first rule says that if the incident ray is parallel to the principal axis, see here, ray AB is parallel to the segment CP here. Okay, so if the incident ray is parallel, this incident ray is parallel to the principal axis, then the incident ray, when reflects back, it passes through the focus itself. It passes through the focus itself. So we can write there in simple statement that if incident ray is parallel to principal axis, reflected ray passes through focus. This is our first rule. Now second rule. For studying the second rule, again we will draw one more diagram. Just suppose that this is a spherical mirror within itself. First principle ka ya first rule ka hame exact vice versa lena hai. We know that this is center of the sphere here and a pole, and through that the line which is passing, that is called principal axis itself. Okay. Abhi yahan pe kahin hum focus denge. This is our focus. So अभी सेकंड रूल क्या है? When the ray passes through the focus, if the incident ray is passing through the focus, then the reflected ray is parallel to the principal axis. The reflected ray is parallel to the principal axis within its own. So we can say that when the ray is passing through the focus, if the incident ray, suppose this is the ray, incident ray AB, this incident ray is passing through the focus, then the reflected ray is parallel to the principal axis. This is parallel to the principal axis. So in words you may write there, incident ray, if passes through focus, then reflected ray is parallel to principal axis. Okay, this is the second rule. Now the third rule we want to study. Very simple rule, the third one. Just suppose that this is one more spherical mirror here. Same thing here, the pole, it's the center, and this is the principal axis. If the incident ray directly strikes on the pole itself, then it makes an angle. Suppose let us consider this is angle theta. So the reflected ray will also make the same angle. The reflected ray will also make the same angle, that is theta. It means that suppose this is starting from point A, A to P, P to B. So we can say that angle APC, which is equal to angle CPB. It means if this angle is of 45 degree, then this angle would be also of 45 degree. In short, we can say that for a concave mirror, if the incident ray is directly passing through the pole, then the reflected ray also makes an equal angle with it, where both the angles are of same value, or if the both the angles make the same measurement. So the next rule, the rule number 4, that is so simple. Just imagine that this is a concave mirror. The same things, center, pole, and this is the focus. So now this rule states us that if the incident ray, now suppose this incident ray is passing through the center of curvature. This incident ray is passing through the center of curvature and it falls on the mirror. Then one thing happens, that the reflected ray also makes or traces the same path. The reflected ray retraces the same path. It is traced by the same path. Simple, I will show you once again. This is a spherical mirror. This is center of curvature. It is the focus and it is its pole. Now let us consider that a ray is incident on the mirror itself from the center of curvature. At that time, the reflected ray, this is the incident ray, the ray which is over here, the ray which is falling, this is the incident ray. But now the reflected ray within itself traces back the same path. The reflected ray will trace back the same path. This is our rule number 4. In word, we can say that if incident ray passes through center of curvature, then reflected ray retraces the path. So these were the 4 rules in all. So revising the rules in short with the help of the diagram, suppose that what is the first rule? Consider a spherical mirror. I will draw 4 diagrams differently over here. So for the first rule, if the incident ray is parallel to the principal axis, then the reflected ray passes through the focus itself. This is our first rule. Then the second rule, similarly, if the incident ray is passing through the focus, then the reflected ray is parallel to the principal axis. The third rule which we were discussing, that is, if the incident ray directly makes an directly strikes at the pole, if the incident ray directly falls on the pole, then the reflected ray also makes an equal angle that of the incident ray with the principal axis. It means both the angles are equal. Then the last fourth one rule, that is, If the incident ray passes through the center of curvature, suppose this is center of curvature, this is pole. If the incident ray passes through the center of curvature, it traces back its path. These are the four rules in all. So after finishing these rules, now we should know about some important notations, because from now on we will be just drawing figures, and we will be telling about the image formations, some of the rules, or how are the objects formed, or what is real image, virtual image, how are they measured. We will be talking about those. So before going to start that, we must be clear with some of the important notations which are really important in the study of spherical mirrors, that may be either concave mirror or that may be either convex mirror. So first of all, starting with the things, suppose that if you are representing any object that is real object, okay, if you are representing any real object on the mirror, then that object distance from the pole, you may call it that, the object distance from the pole is always given by small u. Suppose this is a mirror over here, here it is the pole, and on this principal axis somewhere this is the object. So the object distance between the pole and the object, this is given by small u. This is given by small u. It is denoted by small u. So object distance is the distance of pole from the object. You may be clear with it. Okay. Now it is important to note that this object is generally placed on the principal axis in upward direction. Either mirror convex ho ya concave ho, principal axis ke upar upward direction mein hi object ko put kiya jata hai. So keep in mind always. Then the second one, the image which is formed, that image distance is given by, suppose somewhere on this concave mirror, here it is the object, and somewhere here the image is formed, somewhere just imaginary, or imaginary, virtual, or anything we may call, the image is formed. This image and the pole here, the pole to this image, the distance between these two is given by small v. The image distance is always denoted by, okay, keep in mind. Then the next thing, the image distance is the distance of image from the pole, which I have told you. Now the third thing which you want to know importantly, the focal length. What is the focal length actually? Suppose this is a mirror, here somewhere center of curvature, this is pole, and this is the focus. So the distance between the focus and the pole is known as focal length. This is given by small f. So the focal length is denoted by small f. Then another important thing which we must know about the mirror itself, that is radius of curvature. This radius of curvature is given by capital R. Yesterday we saw the relation R is equal to twice of F, or F is equal to R by 2. This is the radius of curvature. Then another one more thing we want to know here, that is height. Height regarding what? This is the height of image. Height of, if suppose that is the height of image, then that is given by h i, that is height of image. And if suppose that is height of object, that is given by h o, that is height of object. So now when we know about both the heights, then if we are calculating the ratio between the height of the image and height of the object, then it gives us magnification, that is noted by small f, that is magnification of the image, that we call it how image is magnified, in how much ratio, that we calculate it with the help of the things. This magnification gives the size of image as compared to the size of object. Okay. So in short, I would like to cover things which I have told you once. Object distance is given by small u. image distance, it is given by small v. Focal length, which is given by small f. Radius of curvature, that is given by capital R. Then height of object, that height of object is given by HO. Then height of image, that is given by HI. And lastly, the magnification of image, that we call linear magnification, that is given by small m. So friends, these were the important notations or important things while studying about the mirrors, or the important notations for the mirrors. So from tomorrow, or for tomorrow, we will be studying the 6 cases of how the object is placed. But before that, after finishing with these important notations, we will be talking about the sign conventions of concave mirror. For tomorrow, what we are going to start, that for that we must know that u means our object distance is always negative. Then the focal length f for a concave mirror, that is always negative. I am talking it for a concave mirror, remember in mind. Okay, these are the few important conclusions we must know first of all. Then while we are talking about v, it is our image distance. This image distance is always negative, but it has exception. That exceptions we will study tomorrow. The exception is that when object is between pole and focus, if the object is between pole and the focus, if the object lies over here, then and then only the image is formed behind the mirror. So it is always negative in the rest of the cases except this case. Then height of the object which is considered, that is always positive, because on the principal axis, whatever that is in upward direction, that is positive, and whatever that is in downward direction, that is negative. Then height of the image, height of the image, that is always positive for virtual and erect image. If the image is virtual and it is erect, erect means in a straight manner, upward direction mein, ise hum erect kahenge, that is erect. So if the image is virtual and erect, then that is always positive. Another one more thing that we must know, that is height of the image is negative for real and inverted image. Height of the image is negative when the image is real and inverted. Matlab agar ulta hua, if the image is in downward inverted hai, to us time pe wo negative hoga. And we must know about the magnification. Magnification is always positive for virtual and erect. यहाँ पे वर्चुअल एंड इरेक्ट के लिए मैग्नीफिकेशन क्या होगा, पॉजिटिव होगा. एंड इफ इट इज रियल एंड इनवर्टेड, देन मैग्नीफिकेशन वुड बी नेगेटिव. सो दीज आर द बेसिक रूल्स. वी विल बी इमेज विजुअलाइजेशन किस तरह से होता है ये हम कल के पोर्शन में देखेंगे. वी विल बी कवरिंग इट इन टुमारो पोर्शन. टिल देन हैव अ गुड टाइम. बाय.